We got some. Thank you. at me?
I think she does a really good job being intentional. Because I was nervous for that. And for some reason, man, she
I ain't like, I'm like, damn. I was on the shit. I would
already been falling.
Two.
I'll just do it.
Good evening. At this time, will our wonderful MCs and first speaker come to the stage?
Y'all can hear me? Y'all can hear me? I need some head nods. All right. Thank you. Everyone at this time, you may be seated. Welcome to the 65th commencement of Fridley High School for the graduating class of 2023. I'm Ben Davis.
And I'm Khalifo Aiden. You know, Ben, it always feels like we're getting paired up for these things. Doesn't it feel like that for you too?
Kinda. I don't even think about it that way. I'm just here for the stage time. Everybody pose.
Oh, I get it now. Clearly, I'm just here to make sure things get done. Well, anyways, we're both excited and humbled to be your MCs for this ceremony. We have a lot of exciting things in store for all of you. We will be hearing from some passionate students and faculty speakers, as well as two wonderful performances from our very own Fridley High School band and choir. This, combined with the reading of the names, is sure to make for a memorable evening.
Hold on, y'all, hold on. I gotta hold my cap. We will always remember these last 4 years that have been full of countless challenges that the class of 2023 has faced with determination and grace, and we got all through together. With high school ending, we want to change it up a bit. We're not doing a top 10 list like the past years, but let's take a moment and flash back on the memories we had in high school, like Fortnite. You know, that game had a real chokehold on us, an addiction, our freshman year.
I know
you had a TikTok addiction for sure. Everybody be in the hallways, just be dancing to music. And
well, yeah, but didn't everyone? I learned a lot of valuable things off that app, you know.
Like what? How to use ChatGPT?
Well, that and other things. I made some friends off that app, too.
You could have been making friends at the homecoming game. Why didn't you go?
I did. Twice. Those games were freezing, though, right?
Yeah, I know the football team, remember, during warm-ups, it started hailing.
It's hard to show school spirit when you're shivering. Though, the pep fests were different.
Yeah, it was nice seeing all the black and gold and that joyness in the gym.
Oh, yeah, weren't you MC for that, too?
Yeah, but the mics was a little messed up.
I know those mics weren't messed up during the plays the theater provided for us. Newsies and the matchmaker were so good.
Yup. Yeah, I heard a lot of commotion about them plays, about how good those were. But there was another show that came back this year.
Huh? What show?
The Culture Show. It gave many students the opportunity to dress up in cultural clothing and perform for other students to see. Man, the good old days.
Well, that's enough reminiscing for now. We have the pleasure this evening of introducing the team that makes Fridley the best place to work and the best place to learn. We have Kelly McConville, Principal of Fridley's Alternative Learning Center, Activities Director Justin Reese, Assistant Principal of Fridley High School, Limey Zarley, Patty Hand, Principal of Fridley High School, the Superintendent of Fridley Public Schools, Dr. Kim Heil. We also have School Board Chair Ross Meisner and Board Members Abdisalam Adam, Jake Carnup, Donna Proido, and Ivana Stark. With all of the introductions made, let's get the ball whirling for our first speaker of the evening, Savannah Yang.
Good
Thank you for the MCs that introduced me. Good evening, class of 2023. My name is Savannah Yang. I want to start by saying thank you to my beloved parents, family, friends, staff, and faculty at Fridley High School, who have helped shape me into the young woman I am today. It is an honor to speak on behalf of Fridley's class of 2023. At the beginning of this year, I made a vision board, and on it I wrote, reflect, learn, and improve so that you can show up better for yourself. We have overcome so much these past 4 years. For example, during our first year of high school, it was cut short by COVID. Fast forward to our sophomore year of high school, it was cut fast forward to our sophomore year, most of us had to adapt to doing school online or trying out hybrid learning. Then came our junior year, where things started to get normal. This was the first actual year that we would return to in-person school as a whole class. The transitions were tricky for many of us because it was not the high school experience we expected. Well, the truth is, change is good. As we are graduating, everyone's senior year hasn't looked the same, and there is so much character to that. I say this because I believe that the pandemic really shaped us into being our own unique individual selves. We have been able to build one of the most crucial times in our lives, basically through the help of others through the internet. Reflecting on the past 4 years is essential because they went by incredibly fast. Reflect on who you were 4 years ago and be proud of who you have become. It is crucial to understand the word reflect, because how can you improve if you do not remember and give grace to the young freshman you were? My aunt once told me, I don't regret my education because of the things I have learned. No one can ever take that away from me. It took me a really long time to understand what she was trying to say, and as time passed, I realized she was trying to say that the gift of learning never stops, so don't ever stop feeding your mind. With that, to succeed, make sure there is room for improvement. Do not give up on yourself. We have come this far, so why should we stop now? We are evolving as time passes, and things will only improve from here. Have gratitude for the people who have helped support you along the way. Be thankful for yourselves and your families. Including the three words reflect, learn, and improve, at the beginning of this year, transformed my life. If you take anything from this speech, remember those three words. Figure out what it means to you and apply it to your life. Look at where we are now. We can finally say, we did it. Congratulations of class of 2023, and I am so proud of us. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Savannah, for that wonderful speech. At this time, would the choir and band members make their way up to the performance areas?
There's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I take feels, every move I make feels, lost with no direction, my faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying, gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain, I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle, sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there, ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. The struggles I'm facing,
struggles I'm facing,
the chances I'm taking.
Sometimes I knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know, but these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most. Yeah, just gotta keep going.
And I gotta be strong. Just keep pushing on. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle, sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there, ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb.
There's always gonna be another mountain, I'm always gonna wanna make it move.
Always gonna be an uphill battle, sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there, ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. Keep the faith, cause it's all about
Mr. Johnson. Thank you, Mr. Johnson and Fridley High School Choir, for that beautiful song. Our second student speaker of this evening is a friend of mine from way back in sixth grade, Alan Karimanovich.
Class of 2023, hi, my name is Alan Karimanovich. Fridley High School, a school filled with love, passion, inspiration, and inclusion. I've been a student of Fridley for 12 years, and I wouldn't have changed it for the world. Fridley gave me a chance to become myself and who I truly grew into. Growing up as a student from a different cultural background, I was always a little frightened, considering all the backlash that happens in the world with people who immigrate, the comments I've experienced in person, but never once at Fridley Public Schools. I owe everything to this school. It has molded me into the man I am today, and I appreciate it. A fun story I love to share is about when I briefly left Fridley. Even though I was not gone for long, I was nervous about returning. What if people forgot Alan? What if people don't want Alan back? A lot of things ran through my mind at this time, and I still remember the month I returned, the amount of people filled with joy, smiling towards me, genuine emotion and happiness for me and only me. It's something I've never ever experienced before. It made me feel a part of something, and that is what Fridley's all about. Love, passion, inspiration, and inclusion. What also makes me love Fridley is the diversity and culture the school brings in. Look at all of our beautiful people. Besides myself, only one, okay. Besides myself, only one other person in the school is Bosnian. We have built a home for many people to be a part of. I am Bosnian. Moj ime je Alen Kahrumanović. Moj roditelji dolazi iz Bosne. And I am grateful to have this opportunity to enroll in the school. Getting brought up in a Bosnian household gave me a lot of different perspective of schooling. My parents' schooling was a lot different. And when it came to getting me prepared, they weren't aware of what to expect. But they always promised to have my back through thick and thin. They were able to witness little Alan become a big Alan, evolving and prospering into the human I am through elementary, middle, and high school. And I'm glad that I can provide that experience for my family. And I am so thankful for Fridley Public Schools allowing this moment to be captured in my own personal timeline. This school was never just a high school to me. It was a home, a place where I had resources, I had friends, I had amazing staff that actually care for their students. It means a lot more than some people may think. Speaking of staff, a special thank you to a woman who changed my life for the better and always believed in me. She goes by the name of Elizabeth Jensen. Liz, Miss Jensen, whatever you prefer, she's my icon. I'm thankful for having her in my life and for Fridley for gracing me the opportunity to step into her path. Miss Grolke, one of my middle school teachers, who I adore as well, told me about this amazing opportunity that Fridley offers, which is AVID. And one of the people that was running it was Miss Jensen. I was skeptical at first, however, but after explaining the college readiness that this course offered, I was very intrigued and excited. I am glad I listened to the advice that was given to me in middle school, because in the second semester in the ninth grade, I had the chance to meet one of my superheroes, Miss Jensen. Since I was first introduced in the middle of our chaotic freshman COVID year, I never looked back, and I was grateful for getting into the AVID program, excited to come to school every day. Miss Jensen helped us as students in her class, study, doing our work, asking questions, asking for help, an available resource to us all. But in terms of me, treating me as one of her own, talking to me privately, giving me solutions, options, steps to go, where to go, what to do. Fridley, and I know from experience, has the most amazing staff members, elementary throughout high school. We are so lucky. They really do believe in you. As a young adult transforming into an adult, it can be super tough to adapt into that. I've had the pleasure of having Miss Jensen, but every one of my classmates here at Fridley High School can say they found a teacher to make them feel welcome. This is what Fridley is all about. It is about this kind of love that we give to each other. It is about this inclusion that we're all about and not letting any one of our members fall behind. I am truly thankful for every staff member here, every worker and student. We all contribute so much to this community and the school. A quote I can best use to explain the school would be one of my favorite journalists, Nora Ephron, who said, "Your education is a dress rehearsal for a life that is yours to lead." I couldn't have asked for a better rehearsal for my way of life. Fridley High School, a school of love, passion, inspiration, and inclusion. And special thank you to some of these people that changed my life. I would just like to thank Miss Jensen, of course, and I know you're watching here, and the librarian. You've changed my life a lot. I appreciate you so much. Miss Grolke, I don't know if you're out here, one of my middle school teachers. You've changed and I become the man I am today because of you. And most importantly, my mother, I see you. Every day you've been fighting for me, you believed in me, and I haven't given up because of you. Before I go, I just want to say, Mom, you're the real MVP.
Thank you, Alan, for your beautiful, heartwarming words. Next, I would like to introduce Veronique Kolibe Nyamiku and Serena Wood to perform the original poem created in honor of the class of 2023.
Hello, like mentioned before, my name is Veronique.
And my name is Serena.
When thinking of a way to celebrate our classmates and our accomplishments, an idea we had was to write a poem.
This is our way of creatively expressing our journey in high school. This is our original poem called The Best Class, original poem by Veronique Golibe Namiku and Serena Wood.
Hello, class of 2023. We made it through and now we get our degree. But we can't forget how we got here. Everything we went through was our key.
Our key to be here, our key to our degree, our key to help the world and society.
Ranging from the bad, important, and fun, look at the things we've done.
We've advocated for our voices. We don't play games,
and we're not society's toys. We've fought for justice, and we'll tell you this. Dante Wright,
George Floyd,
Andre Hill,
Breonna Taylor,
Alton Sterling and Baton Rouge, just
to name a few. But that's not all we do.
We brought back the dances and had many other advances.
From lunches to sports, we did it all with the staff's support.
We rejuvenated clubs that are more active today. We left our mark, starting with Culture Day.
Dusty alarms and missing heaters, yeah, that's whack. Junior year online schooling all gave us flashbacks.
With the messed up computer speakers, we all became lip readers.
Freshman year was only half a year and socializing just disappeared. And keep this noted, we did it all through COVID.
Online schooling and Google Meets, we are all still in these seats.
Edgenuity was traumatizing and it felt like it was just memorizing.
Seeing some of our friends was amazing after only seeing them on a computer screen.
Honestly, it was sanity saving. It just became our new routine.
Wednesdays were our favorites and we all savored it. But here we sit.
Graduating two nights, but we're not at our height.
And we could tell them, yeah, that's right, and the world's gonna see we're the best class 2023!
We are, I ain't gonna lie. Thank you, Serena and Veronique. That was amazing. Now, for the musical stylings of Fridley High School's band performing music, How to Train Your Dragon. Composed by John Powell and arranged by Sean O'Loughlin, under the direction of Zach Sander.
Thank you.
Thank you, Miss. Ooh, whoa. Come on now. All right. Thank you, Mrs. Snatter and Fridley High School Concert Band. At this time, will all the band and choir members please return to your seats? We have our one last student speaker tonight. Please welcome Fridley's Athena Award winner, Amirami Ruiz Barrios.
Good evening, friends, family, teachers, faculty, and class of 2023. Mi nombre es Amirami Ruiz Barrios. Sorry. It is my honor to speak at commencement today. Class of 2023, we made it. The day we had been dreaming about ever since we were in elementary school is finally here. In September of 2019, we started our first day at Fridley High School. We showed up to orientation with mixed emotions about what the following years would be like. Without knowing that our typical learning style would be replaced in a few months. As we started our second semester of freshman year, our future seemed to be taken into a spiral with different outcomes to an unknown future. COVID held us hostage in our homes for almost half of our high school life before we could return to a typical learning style at school. We made it through quarantine by watching our teachers lecture through a screen and wearing face masks in school. But most importantly, we learned to push through barriers. Online and hybrid school was a barrier for us, a barrier we learned to overcome by finding ways to feel supported and connected. We shared how our pets were being scholars with us through online learning. We wore our PJs as we learned new mathematical equations. And we learned to wear face masks as we competed in sports and clubs. As we head into our new chapter in life, we must remember that there will be barriers along the way. But being able to overcome them depends on our commitment to break them down. It is okay to feel like our life is unknown, and our present may test us with a lot of barriers along the way. The strength of our minds and voices will continue to shine through these barriers as long as we don't give up. Building our confidence and striving for a better future with the knowledge we have from prior experiences will help us find our ideal life. We must understand that we each hold a different purpose in life and that each path will be different for every single one of us. Being at different spots in life is okay as long as we continue pursuing our goals. We must focus on competing only with ourselves to become our best version day by day. As a Mexican-American woman, I have experienced barriers and watched my family go through them as well. Learning a new language and being in a country without your loved ones is a barrier my family has overcame with their commitment to achieving in a better future. My lovely parents' commitment to pursuing their ideal future inspires me daily. It encourages me to continue fulfilling the dreams they've had since the first day in America. My parents often say, "Échale ganas, mija." They remind me to keep going, that there are opportunities for us young people. Their encouraging words provide me with the support I needed to overcome my barriers and feel confident about the unknowns in my future. Look around. Look at our lovely, diverse student body. Just being here together and celebrating our accomplishments in high school proves we broke barriers together. I encourage the class of 2023 to continue to break barriers, continue helping one another to pursue our dreams, and continue to break the unhealthy barriers in society. It is in our hands as a new generation to continue breaking barriers for future generations. We have the power to accomplish our dreams. Class of 2023, I challenge you to continue breaking barriers by using your knowledge and voice that began here at Fridley High School. Thank you.
Thank you, Ami, for that beautiful speech. Tonight has been really exciting so far. Great speakers, amazing music, profound poetry, and the best outdoor venue. Here to help us continue this celebration is the amazing principal of Fridley High School, Miss Patty Hand.
Good evening. Graduates, I promise you no rain. So we're lucky.
I'm deeply honored and grateful to share this incredible celebration with you. We were able to engage with each other for a full school year without any interruptions. You've had a tumultuous 4 years, and your resilience demonstrates how amazing your class really is. Thank you, seniors, for your efforts, perseverance, and hard work. I also want to thank our families for all their collaboration and support throughout your students' educational journey. We are here today recognizing our amazing senior class of 2023. I am so proud to be your principal. A celebration like this is not easy to coordinate, so before we continue, a few thank yous are in order. I would like to begin by giving a huge shout out to our deans, Amy Engler, Jessica Miller-Johnson, Jim Cummings, and Eric Redepenning, who have worked tirelessly to support our seniors over their high school years. Your hard work is much appreciated by me and our seniors. Please stand and be recognized. Thank you. Next, I would like to recognize and thank Fatima Al-Nizami, my administrative assistant, who coordinated this event this evening. Her attention to detail and efforts make this night one we will remember for a long time. Fatima, take a step out on that track and be recognized. Thank you so much, Fatima. I also want to thank and recognize Mike Wilmes and Eric Redepenning for collaborating and preparing our high school staff who are helping with this ceremony tonight. Their efforts are making this event a safe and welcoming experience for our community. Please stand and be recognized. Looking around, not sure quite where they are, but we appreciate you. I also want to recognize Michelle Miner, who put together the graduation tickets and all the signage for graduation. These special touches are so appreciated. Please stand and be recognized. Thank you, Michelle. I would like to extend much appreciation to Mr. Sander and Mr. Johnson, our band and choir directors, for their leadership and commitment to excellence of our music programs. The music is beautiful. Please stand and be recognized. Thank you. Also, a huge thank you to Tim Buttweiler and the custodial staff who helped with the setup for tonight's event. Thank you to our communications department, led by Josh Collins, Mary Henry, Matt Carlisle, Dan Wold, Lance Bailey, Nick Grady, Matt Nalepka, Ann Matthews, and the technology department, led by Yvonne Anderson, for their video and sound production for tonight's events. We appreciate all of your hard work that goes into streaming and documenting graduation. Thank you so much. A special thank you to Alyssa Phelps for her support with our student speakers and MCs as they put the final touches on their speeches this evening. Alyssa, please stand and be recognized. And to our entire faculty staff who are all over this event tonight, thank you so much for your dedication to the education of our seniors. Thank you for being role models, mentors, and for believing in the success of each and every student matters. Please stand and be recognized for your work. Thank you, staff. And to the families of these graduates, I want to thank you for your support and collaboration as we have worked together to support our students find success. We deeply appreciate these relationships. Graduates, please give a round of applause to your families. Now let's get back to honoring our Fridley High School's class of 2023. I would like to recognize the many honor students represented in this class. The first group of students are being recognized for their choice to complete the full International Baccalaureate Diploma Program and are recognized as full diploma candidates. This is the most rigorous course of study students can complete. These students have completed 6 college-level courses and examinations over the course of 2 years. Students, please stand and be recognized. Thank you. Congratulations to all of you. Next, I would like to recognize our IB scholars. These students completed 4 or more International Baccalaureate Diploma courses. Would these students please stand? Congratulations to our IB scholars.
Now, would all the students with a 3.25 to 3.49 GPA graduating with honors please stand and be recognized? Congratulations. Would all the students with a 3.5 to 3.74 GPA graduating with high honors please stand and be recognized? Congratulations to all of you. Finally, will all students graduating with the highest honors please stand and be recognized? These students have a 3.75 or above GPA and have taken a minimum of 3 IB diploma courses. Congratulations. Thank you. The class of 2023 will acknowledge our ninth class of AVID seniors. These students have taken the responsibilities to embark on a rigorous academic journey that starts and ends with a college degree. Would our AVID seniors please stand and be recognized? Thank you. We also have students who, in addition to meeting high school graduation requirements, have also earned an associate degree while attending a local college or university. Would these students who have also earned an AA degree please stand and be recognized? Congratulations. We are so proud of our students and recognize their many accomplishments over their time here at Fridley High School. Thank you. At this time, I would like to welcome Khalifa back to the podium.
Thanks, guys. And thank you, Ms. Hand. Also sharing his words of wisdom tonight is tonight's staff speaker, Matt Kiefer. On behalf of the entire class of 2023, we want to thank you for everything you have done for us. You began during our freshman year and have seen us grow with your own two eyes. You were one of the staff members that all of us hoped would never leave. You made an impact on me, other than my mom, my dad, and my brother Mustaf. And I'm sure you made an impact on everybody's future as well. So without further ado, here's the student-selected staff speaker for tonight, Matt Kiefer.
Good evening. My name is Matt Kiefer, and I have a pretty cool job. I work for the Get Ready program, a college and career readiness program that places people like me in middle and high schools around the state of Minnesota to improve their college and career-going culture. A little over 4 years ago, I was anxiously awaiting the decision of what high school I was going to be placed at. I could have been sent anywhere. Moments like this can really dictate the path of your life. And in this moment, it was decided that my path went directly to Fridley High School. And I'm thankful each and every day for that. Personally, I don't believe everything happens for a reason, but I do believe the stars align every once in a while. Me coming to Fridley was one of those moments. This job has afforded me so many great things the past 4 years. But the greatest thing that I have done is getting to know the students in front of me, the class of 2023. You see, when I started 4 years ago, I was assigned to work with the incoming freshman class, the class of 2023, a class full of distinct personalities and undeniable potential. It was my job to get to know each and every one of you and help you with your post-secondary goals. I am blessed to have had that opportunity. I have watched you grow from awkward freshmen trying to find your place at Fridley High School to confident seniors ready to take on the world. In this moment, I am grateful. Grateful to be in front of colleagues, parents, family members, community members, but most of all, I am grateful to be chosen as the staff speaker by the class of 2023. It has been my distinct honor to play a part in the planning of your lives after graduation. To get to this moment, you have had to endure fierce challenges and overcome obstacles no one could have predicted. Your freshman year began as usual, but the world quickly turned upside down to a global pandemic. You had to endure close to 2 years of distance learning. Over your time in distance learning, you faced a new normal of education, Your classroom became a Google web page. You attended class in the safety of your homes, and you mastered keeping your cameras off during Google Meets. Despite the adversity you faced, you returned to in-person learning to Fridley High School in 2022, ready to take on the challenges of your senior year and eager to make memories with your classmates and with your friends. And now that your senior year is officially coming to a close, you have the rest of your lives just waiting for you. Audience members, in front of you today are the next generation of teachers, mechanics, veterinarians, marketers, pipe fitters, psychologists, cybersecurity specialists, real estate agents, social workers, business analysts, electricians, chefs, dental hygienists, tattoo artists, nurses, soldiers, animators, politicians, welders, paramedics, business owners, nonprofit organizers, engineers, fashion designers, mental health therapists, barbers, coaches, plumbers, filmmakers, architects, cosmetologists, community activists, personal trainers, graphic designers, pediatricians, the list literally goes on and on. We are surrounded by the future today. Graduates, for the 4 years that I have worked with you, I have four final pieces of advice that I want you to remember and to take with you. Class of 2023, you are going into a world that seems to exist one 10-second video at a time, coming at you in rapid succession. I have a challenge for you. I challenge you to be present in moments just like the one we're having today. Be intentional about slowing down every once in a while, taking your surroundings, the things you see, the sounds you hear, the people you are with, and reflect on all the good things in your life, big and small. Each of you will go through unique challenges and unexpected challenges in your life, and I believe it's beneficial to have moments just like the one we're having today to look back on and reflect on with clarity. Remember what got you here today and all the things that you've accomplished in your life, and use that as motivation whenever you are questioning your worth or your ability. Life gets difficult at times, graduates, so please remember to slow down and focus on how wonderfully talented each and every one of you are. My second piece of advice is about investment. Life is not only about how much we invest in ourselves, but how much we invest in those around us. I know many of you have aspirations of leaving Fridley High School and becoming the next multimillionaire or billionaire as soon as you can. Y'all know who you are. We have some real hustlers in the class of 2023. Money is important, don't get me wrong, but I believe the investment with the greatest return is the investment in those around us. Your community is something that will rally around you through good times and through bad times, so that support network is something that is so valuable. Graduates, I want you to also never underestimate the power of kindness. I challenge you to choose kindness today and every day. With friends, with loved ones, and especially with strangers where you have nothing to gain. Everything that I have that truly means something to me was earned because I worked hard and I was kind. In today's world, it sometimes feels like hatred and division are spreading at an uncontrollable rate. Remember, kindness is contagious too. Someone just has to be the one to start. Smile and watch the world smile back, seniors. I truly believe that. Choose kindness whenever you can, class of 2023. And finally, I want each and every one of you to find your own version of happiness. You all deserve to be happy. I am going to repeat that. Class of 2023, you deserve to be happy and to be fulfilled. The biggest challenge is discovering what that happiness and fulfillment looks like. This will be a very personal journey. So remember to take risks, try new things whenever possible, and challenge yourself to secure this definition. Now all you have to do is go out there and find it. As I look out at each and every one of you right now, I am realizing something. I honestly don't know what this school is like without you in it. You all have been the constant in my life the last 4 years at Fridley High School. I'll honestly be sad when next school year comes around and I won't be able to walk the halls and see y'all every day, smile, and ask how your day is going and if you're finally going to complete that FAFSA. But I guarantee you one thing. Next school year, as I walk the halls, I'll still be smiling because I know you'll be out there in the world making it a better place. Congratulations, class of 2023. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Hawa Ali. And Mr. Kiefer, thank you so much for everything you've done. I would like, on behalf of the class, to give you our thank you gift. We wrote thank you cards just yesterday, and we were able to fill them all. Thank you. You've helped every single one of us get to where we are and know where our future is. And for that, I thank you.
Dang, Kiefer, it's getting a little dusty out here. So, getting a little. You almost got weak. You almost got weak, Kiefer. I seen it in your eyes. How about another round of applause for my man, Mr. Kiefer? Oh, go ahead. Before we go, we would like to bring Principal Hand back to the podium.
It has been a pleasure emceeing tonight's commencement. And once again, congratulations, class of 2020.
Hold on. Something just came to me. Before I graduate, I would like to shout out my mom in the crowd. I would like to shout out Aaron Green. I see you, Aaron. I would like to shout out Ms. Bachmeyer. I see you over there. You ain't hiding from nobody. Anderson, man, you was tough on me, but you know, I'm coachable, so I like that. Ms. Winkle, man, you know what I'm saying? You my dog. Mr. Cummins, man, we ain't talk too much, but you my dean, so you know you day one. You know, Ms. Phelps, thank you. I'd like to thank Ms. Hand for, you know, letting me be MC. You know, all the teachers back here. Ms. Johnson, you know, I'm going to see you Friday. You know, track meet. And, you know, yeah, that's all I really got to say.
I want to thank some people, too. I want to say thank you to Mehbo, because I see you raising your hand. My sister, Khadija, because she's been there through everything. My brother, Abdi Basit, because he gives me money a lot. Thank you. My mom, my dad. Everyone in my family, Frahiya, Idil, Ibrahim, Abdullah, everyone, I love you guys. Waya Khalifa. Thank you to all my classmates. These 4 years were amazing. Thank you. And also, thank you for all the assignments you send. I love you guys. You guys are great. Yeah.
Yeah, shout out my homies in the crowd. And shout out my dad. I forgot you, Dad. All right. You feel me? I shout out Dad. I ain't never going to forget you next time. But with that being said, one last time, we got to take it back to the Pet Fest. We are the class of... I don't think that's right. I don't think y'all really cheer for us. We are the class of... All right, we have to do it one more time just for the sophomores and juniors that think they won. And the freshmen. One more time. We are the class of... There we go. Give it a round of applause for yourselves.
All right. Khalifa and Ben, thank you so much for your hard work and leadership to MC our graduation tonight. Your positive energy brought a special touch to tonight's ceremony, and we are so thankful for your contribution. At this time, you may now rejoin your class.
Thank you so much.
I also want to thank Amirami, Alan, Savannah, Serena, and Veronique for their leadership tonight. It is not an easy task to speak at graduation and represent your class, and I am so proud of you all. Your speeches were personal, heartfelt, and classy. Thank you. Finally, yeah, let's give them one more round of applause. Absolutely. Finally, I have the pleasure of introducing the superintendent of Fridley Schools, Dr. Heil. She leads with vision and focus in serving our community. We are so grateful and appreciative of all the support she gives to our students, staff, families, and community every day. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Heil.
Thank you. All right, I'm the last speech before you get to come up on stage, and it's brief, so this will be good. So good evening, parents, guardians, relatives, and friends of our 2023 graduating class. My name is Dr. Kim Heil, and a proud current superintendent of Fridley Public Schools. Most of all, good evening to our incredible scholars who will be graduating this evening. We have all experienced times in our lives where we come across something really special, and it literally stops you in your busy routine of life and say, stop and take this in. This graduating scholars was that moment for me. Words really doesn't give this class justice, but let's just drop a few anyway. Respectful, brilliant, strategic, reflective, caring, tenacious, passionate, hilarious, and most of all, good trouble. There's been more voice in this graduating class towards impacting the work in our school district than ever before. Our students have provided the high school administration, staff, and me personally on initiatives and work that they would like to see and have in the district. Some even set on developing our new strategic plan. They entered each conversation, not looking for trouble, but instead drive the work to make good trouble. The words good trouble was part of the speech by Congressman John Lewis, who is a prominent political leader and activist. He believed in creating a beloved community where he was committed to keep fighting for all in productive protests when needed. He stated, speak up, speak out, get in the way, get into good trouble. This senior class did just that. Their voices were heard and their ideas were implemented. They came in respectful, knowledgeable, and creative in solving problems. Congressman Lewis also stated, this is what we believed in, what we were all about, a mass movement, and it was an irresistible movement of masses, not a handful of lawyers in a closed courtroom, but hundreds, thousands of everyday people taking their cause and beliefs to the street. Graduating class of 2023, remember to always ensure your voice is valued and heard. Make sure your voice is in the room where decisions are made that will impact your life. Come in softly, come in knowledgeable, and come in to make collaborative decisions. But most of all, you must come in the room. And when you do, make some good trouble. Congratulations, scholars, on making an impact at Fridley Public Schools and for all the future positive impact you will make in this world. It's simply there waiting for you to take. You have made a difference in my world, and I thank each and every one of you. Go Tigers. All right, and now for the moment we've been waiting for. Would the members of class 2023 please stand? Members of the Fridley School Board, the members of this class has fulfilled all the requirements for graduation from this school as set forth by the State Board of Education and the Board of Education of Fridley School District 14. In recognition of this achievement, they are entitled to their diplomas as graduates of Fridley High School. Chairperson Ross Meisner, at this time, the class of 2023 will be called to the stage to receive their diplomas. Row one, you may begin making your way to the stage. The rest of you may be seated.
Abdullahi Abdi. Ridwan Abdi. Sadiq Abdi. Kadaris Abdullahi. Shamarki Abdullahi. Bilal Abdo. Ayub Abdul Qadir. Saad Abdullah. Abdi Hakim Abdullahi. Demarian Abrams. Khalifa Adin. Amariana Agnew. Iman Ahmed. Merkeni Ahmed. Yusuf Al-Hayali. Amir Ali. Hawa Ali. Sadiq Ali. Samakab Ali. Suhaib Ali. Prince Ali. Marcelo Allen. Jocelyn Alvarado Campoverde. Marquise Anderson. Quincy Anon. Gabriel Arica. Dolapo Ayudele. Sueda Bashir. Fernanda Beltran Lopez. Prima Bukta. Anna Blackner. Kaylee Brown. Hannah Burdick. Crystal Green. Benjamin Foxhoven. Darius Burks. Alana Carlson. Juan Carmona Martinez. Tatiana Carter. Renato Chino Hidalgo. Mason Clapp. Bianca Criollo Parra. Jakiah Culverson. Jasmine Cusco. Benjamin Davis. Johanna Delp. Kayla Deshane. Duchelle Diom. Samsam Duale. Hamdi Daib. Carter Dodge. Sahur Dalal. Jordan Ebensteiner. Shatha Elker. Davion Ellis. Mohammed Elyamani. Abdulrahman Farah. Camila Faz. Aiden Finnis. Kenshin Foss. Leilani Frazier. Junie Frazier. Jaden Gardner. Gavin Gerhard. Sidra Gori. Revet Gono. Stephen Granger. Courtney Green. Lex Hammer.
Talia, right?
Talia Harden. Hector Guatemala Morales. Keone Harris. Kyla Harris. Thomas Harview. Selma Hassan. Yasin Hassan. Sage here. Cosette Hendrickson. Cassandra Herman. Andre Higgins. Diamante Hudson. Aaliyah Hurd. Murad Hussein. Salma Hussein.
It's okay. It's okay. I know.
Samaya Hussein. Anthony Kalmis. Sabir Jabril.
Yes, we know you, Dietrich. Dietrich, right?
Dietrich Giles. Diana Johnson. Samaria Jones. Jose Juarez Aldave. Kevin Juarez Guzman. Alan Kahramanovich. Alex Kaiser. Ismar Kalisic. Kale Karsten. Mubarak Kasim. Fatima Katham. Bashir Khan. Mohammed Khan. Sarah Khatib. Veronique Kolibe Nyamiku. Annabella Kotash. Norabel Kazaki. Lennon Kruger. Anna Lafreniere. Brenna Lightshoe. Devin Lowe. Angel Lopez Garcia. Andy Lohr. Abdirahman Mohammed. Brunel Marcus. Gabriel Mejia. Anastasia Menyonger.
Best name on earth.
Connor Mobakin. Tank Moger. Abdi Salan Mohammed. Mohammed Mohammed.
Wait, oh.
Yusra Mohammed. Ismail Mohammoud. Jennifer Montano Juarez. Alessandra Morales. Yulisa Morales. Angelique Morgan. Andrew Moses Jr. Nicholas Moclomelo. Anthony Robles Alvarado. Muna Musa. Abdulrahman Musa. Ariel Demery. Ja'Kai Napier. MJ Newton. Ian Norling. George Nianplu. Aina Shafi. Michael Olabai. Madeline Ohm. Henry Ochery. Janoop Pal. Iman Parker. Jessica Payan. Bennett Perez Samaniego. Abdi Rahim Kabdid. Heaven Ryerson. Jack Reynolds. Anaya Rhodes. Nicholas Richard. Videl Hernandez Rosales. Amai Rami Ruiz Barrios. Isabella Sanchez Guadarrama. Eddie Sanders. Muna Saeed.
Jabril Samatar.
Tenzin Sange. Carlos Santanero Salazar. Joseph Sayers. Anders Schmidt. Joe Schwitters. Annette Sadlock. Balram Sariam. Salman Shafi. Ashley Sharp. Najma Sheikh Ali. Ridwan Sheikh Mohammed. Tenzin Sherpa. Asiya Sheikh Ahmed.
Just wait, bud. For the noise to die.
Meyer Suncarly. Noah Soto. Terrence Straub. Jocelyn Spalding. Hannah Stacy. Arixen Sufian. Jude Techi. Jaden Tastel. Hu Hua Tao. Laura Tao. Saria Tao.
Kirom? Yeah.
Kirom Thompson. Nathan Thorpe. Carlos Toapante Alquia. Mohamed Touré. Khalid Toura. Luis Valdivieso, Viezo Bravo. Eric Valtieres. Jose Vargas III. Carmela Vasquez Ramirez. Alexis Vasquez Vasquez. Mara Visker. Molly Vu. Valerie Finn Wakias. Ely Wilfred. Nyla Wilson. Samaya, right? Samaya Womack. Serena Wood. Jamal Woods. Chance Wyatt. Boomer Zhang. Eli Yang. Kalia Yang. Savannah Yang. Abdi Basid Yassin. Suhaib Yusuf. Zamzam Yusuf. Madison Zakar.
Before I get to the final words for tonight, I want to remind the students that you will be exiting the field down by the scoreboard. You will see your teachers lined up down there, and they will direct you where to go. Friends and families, you'll be able to connect graduates in the parking lot. Graduates, at this time, please stand. I present to you Fridley's High School Class of 2023. Congratulations.